morning. Today is the first day that I'm filming from up here. Please let me know if you prefer me filming like this or what I did before from the side. I'd like to know. Yesterday I made this one. I hope you can see it like this. And people wanted to see a video about how I did that, so I will. It's still a little bit wet. So that's what I'll do. I'll make it on a bigger canvas. I used the Artesa colors neon pink. I hope you can see it like this and it will focus. The mid yellow and let me see, the orange yellow, and I have some black from Van Bleiswijk. I already pre-mixed my paints in a, where it says an eye above here. There's a video about how I mix them. Okay, I did use the ping pong cup, and I hope you can see that, but it's a cup, for a lemonade cup and a shot glass, and I just glued the shot glass in the cup. And what I will do first is I have, here are my colors. I have put some dimethicone or silicone oil in these cups, so in all the colors. And first I will throw in the yellow in the middle cup, so in the shot glass. I will fill it about halfway. And yesterday I only, with this one, I used only the yellow and the pink. But today I will add a little bit orange because I think that will look nice. Now I will pour from up high a little bit orange in the yellow. And I will fill it to the top with the pink. It didn't go right up the top. Let me get a little bit more, because I did pre-mix some more. And just pour it in from up high. Okay, and now I will fill the side, so in the big cup, with the black, and I'll try not to touch the shot glass. Oh, but that's hard. And now I will just let it flow into the shot glass. Okay. Now I will put my canvas on it and turn it upside down. I'll just put that out of the way. And now I will pour some black all around it. To help it flow all to the sides. I will divide it with my palette knife a little bit. is we'll do this, but I can always pour on some more black later. And I will look at the sides of the canvas also later after the pour. Okay. Now I will get the painting and or the canvas and put it a little bit higher from where I'm pouring, and then I'm just going to slide it and pull it like this. Now just hope that the colors will come through, because yesterday of course I used a lot less black, because the canvas was smaller. But I was trying to make a, how do you call that, a nebula. And I think that is just what I'm doing right now. I hope you can still see. You can see the colors popping through pretty nice. So now I will torch it, because there is silicone in it and we like that to react. And of course I like to pop out all the air bubbles. But yeah, it's working again, and I think it looks like something outer space. When I'm finished the video, I will get my camera and make a close-up for you. Yeah, I love this one too. So the first one yesterday was not an accident. The paint pump really works pretty well if you like to do something outer space or a nebula, or how do you call that? I don't know. A galaxy. Yeah, I like this very, very much. Now let me see if the sides are covered well. I think once this painting is dry and you will varnish it or put on some varnish or a resin, this painting will really, really pop. And I don't know, I just like this kind of things. So I hope I gave you the enough to work on and do this yourself. If you are gonna try this, please show me the results. I really love it when people write to me on Facebook and show me what they did. I love to see that. Yay. Okay. Well, this was a short video, but well, as you can see, I think this is one that everybody can do. It's no rocket science. It's just playing and having fun. Okay, I will get my camera, give you a close-up. I hope you like my video. Don't forget to subscribe. And the link of the paints I used will be below in the text. So you can see with the web links, so you can see where to buy them. And I will give a description there. Okay, well, thank you guys. Look me up on Facebook or Instagram or whatever. And I will see you there. Okay, bye bye.